all our sanctuary cyber friends and family. Thank you so much for joining us today. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you for joining us here at Prayer House Church of God by Faith. We're located at 270 Cumberland Street in Rochester, New York, where our pastor is Elder George Daly. And we're so glad to have you join us to make your home our sanctuary. We really, really appreciate that. And we look forward to sharing with you again today.
Yes.
So I'm asking now, if you would, prepare yourselves for a word of God. It is coming. It's going to come fast and furious. Amen.
Amen.
That word is going to help you today.
Thank you.
To help you see your way through
Jesus.
Some of the things that may have had you bogged down this week.
Yes. Yes.
And I look forward to it. I personally need to hear that word.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So gather your family.
Yeah.
Call your friends. Yeah. Give them a text. Let them know that the service has begun.
Yeah.
And if they need a word, to join you as you join your cyber church.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And right now we're going to have our praise leader come forth and take us up in song.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Glory to God. God is good.
Yes, He is.
He deserves the praise.
Yeah.
We're ready to give Him.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
The Lord has kept us.
Yes.
And we're safe and here again. Praise the Lord.
Oh, yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
you. Hallelujah. Our God's wonderful.
Yeah.
His ways are past man now.
Yeah.
And we just give Him all the glory.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to your name.
Yes.
Glory to God. Glory to your name.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
You deserve the glory.
Amen.
Understanding, God, as we begin to move forward,
forward, God.
Yes.
Coming out of this pandemic, God, that you would give us the plan, God. You would give us how to, the know-how, the way, God. How to, God. In the name of God. You said, we're going to ask anything in your name, God. Oh, God. You said, we're about you and your body. That's what we're asking anything, God. So we're asking right now in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
That you bring healing upon our land,
God.
Bring healing, God, in our homes. God, you bring healing in our communities. God, you bring healing, God, in our bodies. God, in the name of Jesus. Touch, oh God, our mission. Touch the church of God by faith. Touch God, our church. God, touch every member of God, whatever they may be. God, whatever they're listening on the road, oh God, from listening to your Zoom, from listening, God, from Facebook, God, from listening, God, we ask God that you're going to the heavens, God, and you're going to touch, God. Reach their heart, God. Let it reach heaven, God. And let you, God, come down and let your light in your spirit, God. Bless the man of God. That he will speak a word, God. A word that will be refreshing to our hearts and our spirits, God. That we can live by, God. That will move us, God. That will move us into action, God. In the name of Jesus. God, we ask that somebody be saved. Somebody be delivered. Somebody be set free, God. In the master's name. God, we give you all the glory.
Hallelujah.
We give you all the praise.
Yes.
It all belongs to you. You are the God, Lord God. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And every knee will shall bow.
Thank you, Lord.
And every tongue shall bow.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
God, we stand.
Yes, Lord.
And we stand right here.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Knowing, God,
yes,
that your word is true.
Yes.
And it will not return on
us. Yes.
We thank you, God, for your love and praise. We thank you, heavenly blessing. All the prayer requests God has to
give you. Everyone
touched on the backs of God.
Everyone
even blessed him, God.
Yes.
Touch those.
Yes.
Who are on the ventilators, who need help right now. Bless their families, God. They will cover, God. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. The doctor
can, go ahead, praise God. If the word of God can, amen, praise God. Now you all. That word of God, as Isaiah, one of the writers said, amen. And like fire, hallelujah, God, oh man, fire, sharpen your bone, praise God. Isaiah 65th chapter in the 24th verse. And it shall come to pass that before they call, listen at this, before they call, he said, I will answer. Yes. While they are yet speaking, I will hear. Praise God.
Thank
before
you.
He call you a call, hallelujah, yeah. He said, I will answer.
Right.
We are serving a mighty God today, right?
Yes,
amen. We are serving a big God today, my brothers and sisters, praise the Lord. And God is so good. Amen. Praise God. And I just want to say a few words of prayer right now. And we go to the word of God. Hallelujah. Our Heavenly Father, yes, again, we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
And we cannot thank you enough because we owe all to you, Lord, because of you, God, we live. Because of you, God, we have our being, Lord. We pray that God bless all our hearts and our souls. Open our ears and our hearts, God, to be receptive of your word, God. For God, you got something for us, Lord. We find life in the word. We find healing in the word. We find strength in the word, God. Because it's life in the word, God. Bless every hero, everyone that's looking here right now. Bless them right now, God. Give them a word, God. In the name of Jesus Christ, God. God, help us, God, to go the next day. And the next day, God. In Jesus' name, we pray, God. The next day, blessing, God. Amen. And amen. Amen. Thank God. Thank you, Lord. We thank God today, praise God.
I'm going
to use, amen, praise God, just for thought, for your consideration, amen, it's already done. I'm saying it's already done, praise God. Yeah, we can consider what God said, it's already done, praise God. All we got to do is just believe what God's word says, isn't that right? Amen, praise God. I want to say, amen, you know, I look at the news and I see what happens around the world, and I know it does something to my heart to see so many lined up in cars. Amen. Someone said it's the first time they ever went in line or drove in a line, amen, to get food. And I looked at a father with three sons, amen. He was saying to some of the asses, said, Father, Daddy, what are we going to eat tonight? Good God Almighty. That thing touched my heart so deeply. Now look at my refrigerator. Hallelujah. How about my Savior? I got food to eat, praise God. I got a place to lay my head.
Yes.
You got a place to lay your head. So that's why I say, well, we got a chance here. We're going to give God some thanks.
Thank you, Lord.
Because we know tomorrow we're going to bring anybody alive. Ain't that right, somebody?
Right.
Amen, praise God.
Amen.
And I know, amen, some people are suffering, amen. They're behind in the bills. They're behind in so many things, praise God. Some are saying, I wonder how I'm going to pay my bill. Worry, amen. But I want to let you know today, my brother and sister, worry will not get it done.
No,
worry will take care of nothing, praise God. But what we need to do is have faith in God. God have faith in me, ain't that right?
Yes.
He said, trust me, praise God. Don't put your trust in man now.
Hallelujah.
No, we're doing the wrong thing here now.
Yeah.
Amen. We can hear, but don't put your trust in man.
Yes.
Put your trust in God, amen. Because
yes.
God got it under control. And yes. How they look, how things are, God still got it under control. Because
yes.
He is God, ain't that right?
Yes.
Amen, praise God. What God wants to do is call on him.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Call on him. I tell you right now, somebody right now ought to call me right now. He's not had a hard hearing. God, no, Lord, help us. God is open to have a prayer, to have a call. God is open, hallelujah. You ought to call me right now, praise God. Somebody need to call on the Lord. I remember, praise God, so many times I called on God. Hallelujah. And God heard my call. He heard my prayer, praise God. I have to show, amen, there's so many Christians, my brother, sister, amen, spend too much time, amen, and need his word.
Well,
yes, my God, worry about this and worry about that. We worry, 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 and worry some more, praise God.
Yep.
But I want to tell you the treasure thing here that as a result of worry, many right now suffer heart attacks.
Yes.
Amen. They're struggling with stroke.
Yes.
Amen. Many have problems with high blood pressure. My God, so many got high blood pressure because they're worried, amen.
Yes.
Worry about how they're going to make it. What's going to take place, praise God?
Yes.
Some have been laboring, amen, and worried, what? Praise the Lord. While others have become nervous, wrecked, praise God. Why? Because they're worried. They can't enjoy worship because they're worried. They can't enjoy life because they're worried. Even at work, all they do is just worry. No matter what, they're still worried. Some have also, yes, it is so, as a result of worry. Life is too short. I want you to think about it now. Life is too short.
Yeah.
Amen. Why worry yourself to death, praise God? We got somebody we can call on.
Yes.
He's waiting and willing, amen, to help us out. Even at work, all they do is worry. Praise the Lord. They worry, worry, worry. What problem we face in life? We have a good God, a mighty God, a big God, and bigger than our problem.
Hallelujah.
We must stop telling God about our big problem and tell our problem about our big God.
Well,
we serve the big God.
Big God.
We serve the mighty God, somebody.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness out there?
Yeah.
I'll be somebody saying amen.
Amen.
I'll be somebody got their hands up waving. I believe somebody will be able to hand out there. Say, yes, Elder David, we got a big God.
Yeah.
He's bigger than anybody, isn't that right?
Uh-huh.
He got all power. It's in his hand. Praise God. And can you have forgotten the subject, the matter of service, some of us is already done.
Hallelujah.
Think about that. It's already done. Amen. Israel is assured that God has not cast them off and promised the comfort of the divine presence during existing tribulation. As a nation, they go through some perilous time, and now God gives them hope. Let me take time momentarily, praise God, and suggest that even in this storm, praise God, we have hope in Jesus. Isn't that right?
Yes.
Remember the disciples in the boat, praise God, going on the other side. Hallelujah. All of a sudden, amen, the storm arose. Praise the Lord. Oh, they thought they were going to die. But they said, Master.
Yes, Lord.
They had a presence of mind and said, Master, I want to say to you today, praise God, have a good presence of mind. Let you know that Jesus is on board.
Yes.
Hallelujah. They said, Master, do you care whether we perish or not? Good God Almighty. Jesus got up, amen, and rebuked that storm. The storm came down on down. It ceased. Didn't he do it? Praise God. I want you to know, amen, praise God. You are never not alone, praise God. Contemporarily, amen, praise God, practically, we are the created handwork of God. As a child, amen, I thought about coming up as a child. My father, praise God, we were kids coming up, amen. And I don't care how big a person is, how tough you look, amen. We had the confidence that our dad, amen, going to take care of us. Amen. My dad didn't beat, I thought my dad didn't beat anybody. Amen, praise God. Because I had no fear. That's why, because of my dad, amen. But you ain't got the fear now.
Hallelujah.
We got a big God.
Yes, sir.
He can take care of any big problem. Can I get
amen
for somebody?
Yes.
Is he able today?
Yes.
Amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Now, there's no need to fear because our divine Father is with us. Praise God. The text says that we have been redeemed. We have been bought with the price.
Yes,
amen. That we could not pay.
Thank
but
you.
This text demonstrates that God saw, amen, and seized up the magic of and that he claimed us for himself.
Thank
I like that. What does he see in us? Amen. What does his son see in us? Praise the Lord. The text says that he called us by his name.
Yes.
The God of my hallelujah. Which suggests a relationship. I like, amen, a God that knows my name.
Yes.
I love that song by Tasha.
Right.
Even Tasha called, amen. He knows my name. Yes. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Boy, I get how God. I love that song. Oh, I got that over and over. And I can help myself, y'all. I go to cry and shed tears. I mean, I'd be weeping, mourning, proud of my life. Think about it, he knows my name.
Yeah.
He's just touching my heart, amen. I'm glad he knows my name.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank
I'm glad he knows my name, praise
thank
God.
You.
I'm his son, praise God. And I thank him for today, praise
thank
God.
You.
Hallelujah. And I realize, amen, he got it under control. Try the determination. The uncertainty come out of our way, isn't that right? He says in John 16:33, in the world you shall have tribulation. But be of good cheer. I have overcome the world, trouble, war, and natural pain that we must accept. Mark 4:4 teaches that when Jesus and the disciples out in the water, as I said earlier, praise God, it got rough when Jesus rebuked the storm. Every now and then I'm alive, I'll testify by you.
Yeah,
don't you think you went through fire sometimes?
Yeah.
If you go through the fire, I will not be burned. Hallelujah. I go through the flood. Hallelujah. Amen. The water. It would not overtake me, praise God. If I'm in the water, about 1 feet deep, praise God, I can step over there.
Uh-huh.
I keep on walking.
Yep.
Go to 2 feet, yeah, I can walk a little bit up. I mean, yeah, more and more. But if it gets 6 feet now,
yep,
I can do that walking, praise God.
Thank
so
you.
Just in case the water overtake me, praise God,
thank
get
you
up out of my head, I will not go under.
Hallelujah.
I want you to follow me here. Because if I get that high, Jesus is right there.
Yes,
I rise above the 6 feet, praise God. Because Jesus is on board.
Yeah.
Tell him thank you somebody.
Thank
you. Tell him thank you somebody.
Thank you.
Amen, praise God. But I want to tell you, amen, that's God that we serve, amen. He's able today, praise God. Psalms 46 and 1 teaches that God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Since he's our refuge, I can find protection in him. Since he's our strength, I can turn from my problem to him. Praise the Lord. Thank the Lord. Since he's a present help, I don't have to wait for him to come for me because he's already here. Somebody say he's already here.
He's already here.
Wherever you are.
Hallelujah.
I don't care if you're in the car.
Yes.
I don't care if you're in the bed. He's already here. He's already there. Down the street. He's already there. So he said, oh my God, I will never leave you. I never forsake you. Sometimes you got friends that say they have a friend. They say they have a friend. But you get in trouble. They ain't got time for you. When you need them, you can't find them. Amen. But Jesus is not like our friend. No, no, no. He'll never leave you. He'll stick by what he said. I'll be with you always. Come on, somebody. He's always out with me.
Thank you, Lord.
I bet some people I thought they were my friend. Uh-huh. Lord, have mercy, Lord. Hit that back here. Uh-huh. I love you. I'm with you, man.
Well,
Lord, sooner or later, turn it back on. I'm quite sure somebody experienced that. Look, I said, where are they? They're gone, man. My uh-huh. Lord, have mercy. You thought they were your friend.
Uh-huh.
But Jesus will be a friend for you.
Uh-huh.
He will never leave you. Can I get a witness?
Uh-huh.
Can I get a witness, praise God? He's always left there. He's left there all the time. Is that right?
Uh-huh.
Somebody has to illustrate now. I know in their life, and their loved ones' life. Don't worry. I want to tell somebody again. Don't you worry.
Hallelujah.
God got it under control.
Yeah.
I want you to get that.
Thank
don't
you.
Worry. It won't change anything. But God got it under control.
Thank
hallelujah.
You.
Praise God. Somebody worry about bills. I know it's time like it is now. You worry about your bill. How they going to get paid. Oh, I'm going to lose this, lose that. But put your trust in God.
Yeah.
God got all power. God got the whole wide world in his hand. He got a human eye. And the kids that come up to sing this song, got a little bit of children.
Yeah.
Baby, yeah, baby. In their hands, amen. You got everybody there. Aren't you glad today? Aren't you glad today? You ought to say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
God about it. From God, God, you praise God. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Amen. Somebody's worried, praise God. Somebody's troubled about relationship. Yeah, you got a broken relationship. You're not doing that good. But put it in God's hand. You can't fix it.
Lord.
Well, our problem sometimes, we try to fix it ourselves. I got the cue for it. I studied this thing. I read the book. I got it in college.
Yeah.
I got it, but something you can't get out of college. You got to get it from God.
Yeah,
come on, somebody.
Yeah,
God, the best theologian in this area, he's the best theologian. Nobody got none God. I'm glad God. Nobody knows more than God. God got to answer. Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody. Put I'm going to get you happy here, man. Because that's good God.
That's all right.
Hallelujah. Right. Hallelujah. God is a big God.
Yes.
We got to trust God somebody.
Yes.
We got to trust God.
Yes.
No matter how high the mountain is, God will take us over. Isn't that right?
Yes.
Okay, how long the valley is, God will take us through the valley.
Yes.
God got us on his hand. Isn't that right?
Yes.
It's already done, praise God.
Yes. Yes.
We don't have to sit around without a head hung down. Sing it in despair. Like a lot of people doing that now. Sing it in despair. Entertaining the enemy at our own pity party. Having a pity party. You know what I'm talking about, somebody out there.
Thank you.
Trying to figure out what our current situation is. The problem is, it's already solved. We serve a God who knows our need even before we ask.
Yes.
Before we ask, God knows what we need. The Lord said even before we ask, he answered. Think about that. Be patient. Stop trying to figure it out. When he has already worked it out on our behalf, leave it to him. Now to him that able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all we can ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us all. Working in us, praise God. So many times we go in that scripture and read it, amen. I tell God, work it, Lord.
Work
it, Lord.
Yeah.
I keep on saying, work it in me, Lord.
Work
it, God. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve, amen.
Yeah.
Often I tell God to work it. What about the God we serve? The valley is the Lord. Stand still.
Yes,
Lord, help me. Sometimes you're tossing, you're wondering, you're running. My God can't keep still. But sometimes you got to stand still.
Yes.
That God told the children of Israel, Moses, stand still.
Yes.
God Almighty. Hallelujah. Stand still.
Stand still.
See the salvation of the Lord.
Yes.
Stand still.
Yes.
Let God work it out.
Yes.
You can't work it out.
Yes.
You can't get it out. and brought them out. They had crossed the Red Sea. Remember that? On dry land. Not knowing how they were going to cross it, amen. But God had already knew 400 years before they got there. See what I'm talking about? You wonder how you're going to make this in. How I'm going to pay my bill. How I'm going to do this and do that and that. God already got it figured out. I want you to get that.
Yes, sir.
You wonder how I'm going to do this. But God got it already figured out. You just keep on following God.
Yeah.
That's all God said. Just keep on following me.
Yeah.
Just keep on following what I'm saying, praise God. And I got it all right now. When you get there, it's already gone.
Amen.
I want you to get there, amen. That Red Sea, man, God knew about it all the time. He knew they were coming that way.
Yes, sir.
But he had already worked out.
Yes, sir.
All I had to do, praise God, just keep on marching. Because God Almighty. When it got there, Lord, that sea just opened up.
Because
God Almighty. Lord, have mercy. I can imagine in my mind, they said, I've never seen anything like this.
Thank you,
we didn't know how we were going to get across this. We didn't have no boat. Amen. But God had it all worked out. Won't God do it, somebody?
Yes, he will.
Won't God do it, praise God?
Hallelujah.
Amen, praise God. It's already done. Joshua 24 chapter 11 through the 13th verse. I'm going to read this scripture here. 24 chapter 11 through the 13th verse. He said, you went over Jordan and came into Jericho. Watch this. And the men of Jericho fought against you. You, the Amorite, and the Perizzites, and the Hittites, and the Jebusites, the Hittites, and the Jebusites. And I have delivered them into your hand. See, God had it all worked out. You might wonder how he's going to get through this battle. But God, the battle is the Lord.
Yes.
Cut the Almighty. Hallelujah. And I sent the hornet. Listen to that before you now. It's already done. I sent the hornet before you. Amen. And told them out before you. Praise God. Even two kings of Amorites. Amen. But not with thy sword, not with your bow. And I have given you the land for which you did not labor. Listen at this. Now, God has already given them land they didn't labor for. Right. Have got there yet now.
Already.
I want you to thought it's already done. I want somebody to get that today.
Already.
What about your healing? Stop worrying. God has it in control. Then Joshua said to the people, now therefore, now as he told them all that, now therefore fear the Lord. And serve him in sincerity and in truth. This should tell us something. This should tell us something. Amen. Praise God. No man, I don't care what they say or what they are talking about, no man can do what God has done.
Praise God.
Nobody can fix it like God can fix it. Amen.
Right.
Healing, I want you to get this somebody. I know somebody's sick. Somebody may be on a deathbed right now. Doctor may told you, amen, you're going to die. Amen. You would not be here, praise God. But I want you to get this today. You claim your healing right now. It's already done. It was done on the cross of Calvary. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. He will whip. Amen. Amen. Praise God. With this strike, we were healed. And I'm saying today, in our day and time, in 2020, we are healed.
Yes.
Oh, God Almighty. Hallelujah. I wish somebody had that same thing to praise God. Say, I'm healed. Praise God.
Amen.
I don't care how I feel. I don't care how bad I got pains in my body.
Thank you, Lord.
I don't care what I'm going to deal with. I am here, praise God. Amen. It's already done. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Financial prosperity has already been provided. Joy and peace and everything that you ever need emotionally have already been provided.
Hallelujah.
If you have a down day, things are not going right. If you don't feel good, well, you don't need to embrace this current. Don't embrace discouragement. Devil wants you to worry. He wants you to embrace discouragement. Oh, discouragement. Hold your head up.
Because
God, throw yourself to God.
Well,
get up and say, my God is able.
Yeah.
Raise your hand, amen, praise God. Amen. If you want to salute God, salute him. Say, my God is able.
Right.
Hallelujah, praise God. I'm not going to stop worrying, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Not in despair and hopeless. There's hope in Christ. Amen. And yet the average Christian just embrace this stuff. Saying, oh, God, I ask you to touch me. Listen at this. God, touch me. I ask you to forgive my, give my joy back. The Bible said you already received all those things. Did he say that? The question is asking us, then where is it? It's already done. I wish somebody who is watching and listening to me right now say, it's already done.
Yeah.
Galatians 5th chapter, 27th, 23rd verse said, but the fruits of the Spirit, amen, and love, hallelujah, is joy, peace, long-suffering, all this in the gentleness, against them. They will have that. Amen. Praise God. It's right there in your spirit. Praise God. I got that. I got it. It's already done. Praise God. That all God has things already put together. It's already in place. Amen. All you got to do is walk in it, believe it, and walk in it. Praise God. There are so many people come and say, I just don't feel the love of God. Well, you let me tell you something right now. I don't feel the love of God. Will you please pray for me? Most people think that it's God's fault that they don't feel his love. The truth is, God has already poured out his love towards us. Am I right, somebody? Romans 6, the 5th chapter, 5th and 6th verse, the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. And verse 6, when we were without strength, Christ died for the ungodly. Now you tell me, you feel like God don't love you? Yeah, that was a lie. God do love you. He gave his only begotten son. Only had one son, but he gave his only begotten son, not for just me, but for the whole wide world. Yeah. Come on, praise God. For God so loved the world. Don't tell me God don't love you. That devil is a liar. He's a liar and the father of lies. Why believe a liar? Amen. Why believe a liar? Ain't he nothing but a liar? Believe what God's word says, praise God. Let a man be true, but God let the devil be a liar. Isn't that right? How could you ever doubt that you are yet without something that you already have? Now you already got it, and you got what you got. Think about it.
Yeah.
It's really that simple. If God could be confused, now look, if God could be confused now, as you know, he's not going to ever confuse. I want you to catch it. He's never confused. I think he will be confused saying, I told them in my word that they were already healed. God Almighty.
Uh-huh.
Already healed.
Uh-huh.
He said, I told you. All you got to do is believe what I said. Praise God. Hallelujah. Prosperous and have total joy and peace in the spirit. Why are they asking me for what they have already had?
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Don't they believe me? Do they think I'm lying? Don't they know, amen, it's impossible for me to lie? Hebrews 6 chapter and 18 verse. Amen. Praise God. When I said amen, I will always be in the midst. Matthew 18, 20. For two or three done in my name, I'm in the midst. He right there. Is that right? Amen. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Did he say that? Why do they ask me to go with them when I said I would never leave them, not forsake them? Hebrews 13, 5. God had already done his part. When Jesus died on the cross, he said, it is finished. John 19, chapter 30, verse, amen. Done deal. And scripture revealed in Ephesians, first chapter, amen, second verse, that he is now seated at the Father's right hand. He's not working anymore. He's already done. It is finished. Somebody ought to say it is finished.
It's finished.
It's not real. We were healed over 2,000 years ago. Do you need a healer today? Somebody out there, I know somebody out there. You need healing today. Yes, you do. Amen. Praise God. But I want you to repeat it. God's faith says, already done. Hallelujah. Already done. Amen. Do you need to be saved today? You all start saying, I'm saved.
Thank you, Lord.
God, he died, amen. That saved us, isn't that right? Yes, he said in 1 John, 2nd chapter, in the 2nd verse, that he is the refrigeration for our sin.
Right.
And not our only, but for the whole wide world. Praise God. The whole wide world. COVID-19 cannot cover like this blood. That cleansed, saved, and healed. Praise God.
He
already forgiven us of our sin. Of the whole entire world. It's not a matter of God. If God will forgive us, we are all ready for
you.
Come on, tell him thank you. But I thank God today.
Thank
I am forgiven. Praise God.
Amen.
Will you receive forgiveness today?
Yes.
Will you put your faith in what Jesus has done?
Yes.
This is up to you to believe it is done. It's already done. God has already forgiven you. I want you to believe that today.
Thank you, Lord.
He's already commanded his best upon you. Your finances. Praise God. He's already given you love and peace. You don't need God to respond to you. You need to learn to respond to God. It's easier to defend something you already have than to go defend something you don't have. This is so powerful. But this is where so many Christians are missing. They know God can do it, but they don't think he's done anything yet. They are at the crossways with the word of God in regard to their healing. The proper way to it is to take Proverbs 18 chapter, 21st verse, death and life. In the power of the tongue.
Yes, sir.
Speak, amen. Save the tongue. Use that tongue to start cussing somebody out. Use that tongue, besides getting stuck confusion, gossiping, whatever the word. Yeah. You then come tongues to other word and say, I am healed.
Yeah.
I speak healing, praise God. In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak life. I speak this sickness. I speak this cure, praise God. I speak death, amen, praise God. Amen. In this sickness, praise God. To this sickness, I speak it, amen. The COVID-19, praise God.
Thank
I curse it. I command it to leave.
Yes.
God, I speak life. Let all that put on the inside of me, I release it to flow through my body. This is how you start cooperating. God, with agreement with him. It's already done, praise God. Because he said so. It's not a matter of trying to get it done. It's not a matter of trying, amen. But God has already moved in your life. It's a matter of you moving over in agreement with him. And receiving what he has already promised.
Thank you.
I am saved.
Hallelujah.
I am healed.
Yes, Lord.
I am Christ.
Hallelujah.
I wish somebody said that there.
Yeah.
I am saved.
Yeah.
I am healed.
I am
prosperous. I am blessed. In the name of Jesus.
Thank
believe it right now. I got to cut it short a little bit. I got to believe it right now, praise. Now come on and give God some praise again. You ought to start saying, I am healed.
I am
blessed. Be what God said, I am healed, I am saved, I am blessed, I will prosper in the name of Jesus. Now give God some praise. I give God some praise. You deserve all the praise. You deserve all the worship. Hallelujah. Oh my God. And everything. You gotta give God some thanks, praise God. Even right now, praise God. Maybe somebody say it again that I want God to come to my life. God will come to your life. Maybe somebody out there right now, you need another Savior. You don't know man, your personal Savior. But I want to tell you today, Christ will save you. Christ will give you, praise God. If anybody out there, praise God, saying I'm tired now. I'm tired of running. I'm tired of doing this and doing that. And not getting it together. It's getting worse and worse. I'm going down, down, down. But Christ will pick you up. And Christ will pick you up. What he do is something like you lift me up, amen. You put you up where you are, praise God. Hallelujah. Come on to the day, praise God. Get ready, open your heart. Let the Lord come into your life today. And I want you to bow your head, somebody. Think about it. Think about it. Where will you spend eternity? If you leave here right now, where will you spend eternity? Where do you think you will go right now? If you leave this earth right now, would it be heaven or would it be hell? But Christ died. That we can have life. But I thank God today. I can say for the person that's willing, I got life. Christ wants to save you. He comes to set you free. You can't free yourself. You can't change yourself. You're going to take God. God Almighty. The power of God to set you free. But I'm saying today, get your heart, open your heart to him. And let him come here right now. Let him change your attitude. Let him change your situation. Let it change your heart. Your heart. When the heart, man, praise God. Man believes, amen. Praise God. I want you to believe God today. Because God is able, praise God. And I want you to bow your head with you right now, wherever you are. Praise God. In your home, amen. In the room. Maybe in the car. Maybe you put aside somewhere stopping, praise God. Just bow your head with us, amen. Praise God. And I want you to let the Lord come into your life. Amen. God will change you. He will change you because the Bible says that a man in Christ. Your new creature, all things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. He that kind of God today, amen. And you tell him you're sorry. You're sorry. I've been walking, remember that sin for so many years. It's not getting down, but it's getting worse and worse and worse. I want you to bow your head with me right now, praise God, and pray Lord Jesus, amen. And say the prayer, amen. So tell him that I am. Know that I'm a sinner, God. And I ask you for forgiveness. Just tell him, forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, God. I have sinned.
Yes.
I have sinned. Yes, I have. I believe that you died. Thank the Lord for my sin. And rose from the grave. Lord, have mercy. I tell for my sins, God Almighty. I invite you right now.
You're
coming to my life. Come to my life, Jesus. I repent right now.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
I want you, God.
Yes.
I want you to God church. I want to find you. I want you to be my Lord and Savior. Tell him. In Romans 10 chapter 9 verse, amen. Confess with thy mouth. The Lord Jesus died
repent of your sin, and you believe it right now, amen, you are start saying, I am saved.
Thank you, Lord.
I am saved.
Yes.
I thank you, Jesus, for saving me.
Thank you.
For giving me another chance.
Thank you.
You are telling right now. Lift your hands and thank you, Jesus. You are praising for it right now.
Thank you.
Give me praise, give me praise. Say, I thank you for coming to my life. Now live for me. Find a church of your choice. Amen. Praise God. And walk with the Lord. And serve Jesus and serve God. Amen. The rest of the days of your life. Amen. If you live, amen, until you return, amen, being saved, you shall see him in peace. Amen. At the time, I have a few announcements. Amen. Praise God. You can have a way. We're going to come at the time. Announcements.
Well, praise the Lord.
Thanks so much.
That was a powerful, powerful word.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I could feel God as Pastor was preaching. Couldn't you?
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. What I see has accomplished for us.
Yes.
He didn't just die on the cross, but he got some stuff done.
Yes.
Behind the scenes.
Oh,
praise the Lord.
Yes.
That we would do well to acquaint ourselves with. Yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus. He's so good.
Yes.
He's wonderful.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
His ways are just past finding out. There's a song that says, can't nobody
do me like Jesus.
Do me like Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 He's our friend, isn't it? Isn't he?
Yes.
He's our friend.
Yes, he is.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That girl said, he knew my name.
Thank you, Lord.
How he walked with me.
Yes. Hallelujah, yes.
Comforts me.
No, he comforts
me.
Yes, he does.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Comforts
me. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
He saved me.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. I'm here to receive.
Oh, my God.
That's all right, sir.
I'm going to stir it up.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
And
thank you for doing it.
I feel God here.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
And I know he's here.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. He's here in this way. Well, the church here.
Thank you, Jesus.
And at Brown.
Thank you,
Jesus. I know you can't be here, but I hope you're having church wherever you are.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And at this time, we're going to talk to you about our offering. God has been good to us.
Yes.
Amen.
If you can hear this broadcast, God has been good to you.
Yes. Yes.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
If you can hear me, God has been good to you.
Yes.
And Pastor says God has loved us well from before the foundation of the world.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
And certainly in He demonstrated it in that he gave his life for us.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. He gave his life that we might we become a son of God. We're made righteous
in
him by the blood of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, right?
Yes.
That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I got everlasting life today.
You got life.
Hallelujah.
You got life. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for life.
I'm not worried about it.
Thank you for life.
And, I like to say, I just like to say it.
Ah, oh, God, thank you. Thank you for life.
I ain't trying to be saved.
No, man. Already.
I'm not working on it.
All right.
Pastor says it's already done.
Already done.
Hallelujah. Thank you. I didn't do it.
You
I didn't see
it,
so I didn't have much to do with it.
Doing it,
except I believe on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank
and
you.
God did the all the rest. Praise the Lord. I'm saved.
Thank you,
I'm saved today.
Thank
praise
you,
the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Glory to God.
Thank you.
Well, I hope you are ready to give your offering. And God has done so much for us.
Thank you, Jesus.
And he just keeps making the way for us. And we're in a time now where we need the Lord to show up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And to show us what he has already written down.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
And if you just settle yourself and believe God, Pastor says that the battle is not ours.
No.
It's the Lord's battle.
Right.
Praise the Lord.
Right.
We who for us who know God, it's his battle.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
And so I'm not fighting. I'm not in a tizzy. I'm comfortable where I am. And I'm confident that God is going to take care of us. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
Let me thank you again for your generosity and your faithfulness and your doing the right and you're doing what God has called you to do.
Yeah.
You have been very good in giving your offerings. And that means that you're also very blessed.
It's already.
If we knew what God said to do.
I'm already blessed. So
thank you, Lord.
I'm already.
He is going to bless us.
Yeah.
Like he said he would.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. He said he would open up the windows of heaven and pour us out a blessing that we would not have room enough to receive it.
Amen.
If you want to know what that's like Peter catching all of those fish after he lent the Lord his boat, and the Lord told him to cast his net over there, and Peter cast his, well, the Lord said, cast your nets with an S on it. But the Bible says Peter cast his net without the S. And the load of fish was so great that one net couldn't hold it all.
No.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
he had to call his partners over in their boats.
Right.
And his boat was loaded down, and their boats were loaded down with fish.
Wow.
I'm looking for God and believing God for that kind of blessing. Mm-hmm. How about you?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. The Lord is faithful to do what he said he would do.
Yes,
it didn't, you know. People say, you plant your seed, and it takes a while before you get your harvest. Well, naturally, it does. But Peter got his blessing in a matter of moments. don't count God out. He can do it right now.
Right.
Praise the Lord. Overload. A boat sinking load.
Right.
Praise the Lord. A net breaking load, if you will. And we're asking you to believe God for your harvest. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
And love him. Love him while you're giving.
Uh-huh.
God loves us if we're cheerful in our giving. Mm-hmm. He loves a cheerful giver.
Right.
And I know I said that last week, but it's just the truth.
Right.
God likes that. And we can't beat God giving.
Right.
Hallelujah. My daughter used to sing a song. You know, she thought she was singing a song that we sang. When we say you can't beat God giving, no matter how you try, no matter how hard you try. But my daughter had her own version. She said, "You can't beat God giving, so you don't have to try." We can't beat God giving, but He does want us to give.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And God has promised to bless us.
Right.
And at this time, we're going to pray that He does.
Yes.
Father, in Jesus' name.
In your name, Jesus.
We thank you for all that you have
done
for us.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for how you have kept us and how you have delivered us.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
God, we know that it was you. It was not us in our own strength. Hallelujah. But you showed up and you blessed us, God, so abundantly. And we are glad, and we praise your holy name for your goodness. Now, God, as your people open up our hearts and love you and give you out of that love what you have desired. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, we ask you that you bless them. Bless them through this time.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Give them their confidence and the assurance that you are with them. Hallelujah, God. Thank you, Jesus. That's what we need in this in a time like this, Lord. We need assurance. We need confidence. Hallelujah, that Pastor was preaching about today. Hallelujah. We ask you, God, that you would do what you do. Hallelujah, with what we give you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You promise to meet all of our needs according to your riches and glory. If we remember that, God, we're sure that you remember. Hallelujah. And just flood us, God, in this time of blessing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Help us all to be a blessing to our neighbors.
Yes.
To our friends.
Yes.
Hallelujah, God. In the name of Jesus, give us the word with all that we can meet others' needs. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Those of you to Prayer House Church of God by Faith, P.O. Box 30108. P.O. Box 30108. Praise the Lord. And the zip code is 14603. 14603. And for those of you who are giving electronically, you may give using Tithely. If you don't have it on your phone, you can download it. And look for Church of God by Faith, Prayer House Church of God by Faith. Look for Prayer House Church of God by Faith and follow the instructions from that point. Hallelujah. God has been good to us.
Yes.
And he's been kind to us, and he's shown us his loving kindness and his tender mercies, and his grace has abounded toward us. And we're so grateful, we're so thankful for it all he has done. And we ask you to give and be blessed. Hallelujah.
All right. Just briefly, announcement. We received information by the bishop. Amen. Church of God by Faith, INC. What we have to call it, International Day of Prayer, calling all men. And call it GAMP GAMP. GAMP GAMP. That means God anointed men praying. And May the 2nd. Right now, May the 2nd, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to be dealing with churches all over 51 major denominations, as well as Liberia, Zambia, Nicaragua, Haiti, and Chile. And we have churches all in the areas over there. We'll be joining together, 51 denomination. Otherwise, so please tune in. Join in on the National Day of Prayer, International, May 2nd, amen, 10 a.m. And also, you can go to Facebook, www.facebook.com, Church of God by Faith, a national organization. Otherwise, you go on Facebook, you can go to a live, otherwise, I'm saying, Facebook, tune in on Facebook, and then you can join in, amen. And some of the words can go online. We call it Praise 107.5 Radio Online. And some of them like Praise 107.5 FM Radio. So, anyway, those are the means you can join in. So, again, National Church of God, I think, of the word Facebook International. So, please join with us on the word on praying at 10 a.m. May the 7th. All right, God bless you. And just join everybody throughout the land when we join in. All right, thank God for you again for tuning in. Amen. May God bless you. May God keep you. And just keep looking up. Amen. God got our control. It's already done. It's already done. At this time, we're going to dismiss in prayer. This is dismissing benediction, love. And we're going to let you on our way. May God keep you until we meet again, until we see you again. See you on Zoom, we see you around different places. We're not here together, let me share together because of what's going on, but we still in contact. Amen. We still in contact. We can see you on Zoom, amen. And what have you, God got things in place. May God bless you, may God keep every one of you all. Keep on saying, it's already done. I am here. I am here. I don't care what you got, I'm here. You keep on saying, right now. Keep on saying it. Now be grace about the Lord. And Savior Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit. Rest, everybody.